Welcome back to the channel, and this is your boy Dilly with another Real Madrid career mode. And this will be the last game of the season as we are facing Spurs in the Champions League final. Disappointing to have lost the Spanish Cup final against Atletico Madrid. That was very, very disappointing. Hopefully next season we can win all the trophies that we are supposed to be winning. But let's get into this game. Hopefully we can redeem ourselves. Let's get it.
It's been a season-long crusade, fitted in, of course, with the domestic commitments of both these clubs. But how well they've done in the Champions Cup to reach this final. I wonder who will prevail. We'll find out shortly enough. Well, this is a great day for the Champions Cup final. It's contested here, it's got to be played to a finish, and hopefully it will live up to the occasion, Alan.
I think so, I think it will, Martin. I hope we rise to the occasion in the way that I think the players will out here today.
Assessing Tottenham Hotspur, I think this man is a potential game changer.
Four goals in his last three games, really does look a class act at the moment.
This is almost on the tourist trail, isn't it?
Kicking off straight from the quarterfinals until the final here, we have had to face all English clubs, can be Spanish giant, that it is Real Madrid. Redeem itself here with a win over Spurs and really try and end the season on a good note here. I think it's going to be massive for us to win the Champions League. We're going to get the ball in here with Gareth Bale. But he doesn't keep the ball in. Gareth Bale still in possession here with the cross in. Cristiano Ronaldo on the far post. But well saved by the goalkeeper here, Hugo Lloris. Going to win the ball back here with Sergio Ramos. Back to Luka Modric. Going to find Cristiano Ronaldo. Cristiano Ronaldo with the finish.
By the scorer of this opening goal in the Champions Cup final.
Well, that could be so early here against
this
Spurs.
This team's got a very good defense.
Let's get it. We do need to win this Champions League. That's the match. After losing the Spurs final against the Atletico,
well, the keeper had no chance.
Real Madrid in front.
Spurs are caught down here by one goal to 2-0.
Toby Alderweireld.
Score another one here before the end of the first half.
Aurier.
This game is actually played at.
It was good progress with this attack. Well, they've got to stop Kane getting within shooting distance as he moves forward here.
Manchester United is where I
tested like his control now.
Come on.
Luka
Modric to lose this ball here. Luka Modric, can you win it back? Spurs coming in here.
Victor Wanyama.
Wanyama back to Dele Alli here. Can find Harry Kane, Son. Back to David Ali here. Come on. Oh, this is Song. Song back to Wayama here with the cross. In it. What a shot.
With a textbook save.
Well defended here by the goalkeeper. We're going to get this ball in it. Oh, Luka Modric to find really Gareth Bale here, find Benzema. Here. Benzema can progress. Benzema break through this defense. Benzema still in possession here with the ball through four. Come on.
One in front,
come on, Verratti.
If they were two
don't tell me you missed.
Really
tell me
been.
That's
yeah,
an offside.
Look back on that with a bit of regret because that was a great chance.
He actually missed it. Oh, come on, Verratti. We should be sitting on two goals to nil at this point.
Aurier.
I need goals in this game, man. I need to be fair.
Jan Vertonghen.
Benzema to win it back here. Benzema for Gareth Bale. Gareth Bale with the cross here back to trying to find Benzema once again. But well blocked. We're going to find Toni Kroos in this one. Toni Kroos with a through ball here trying to find
very good
Benzema.
Indeed,
there.
Here they are on the attack.
Luka Modric coming forward for Benzema. Back to Cristiano Ronaldo. Can he make it two? Cristiano Ronaldo makes it two goals. He has come alive in this final, that's for sure. Cristiano Ronaldo sitting on a hat trick. Can he actually get his hat trick?
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special. And he is feeling that special delight at the moment. Restarting at 2-0.
Wanyama, Dele Alli, on the English soil. Now this looks promising. Come on, Wanyama comes with the ball here.
It's Eric Dier. Tried to tackle it, and he's done that.
Trying to find the bands.
Jan Vertonghen here, but Benzema able to cut that out.
Find Gareth Bale here.
Bale's got
BBC. Cristiano for Ronaldo for Bale.
Bale, a brilliant goal from
Bale with a massive, massive goal here to give us a comfortable, comfortable 3-0 to win against Tottenham. It is coming home, son. It is coming home.
For Real Madrid. They're just emphasizing their superiority and widening the margin.
Yeah, I think so. And you look at their overall play, they've deserved it.
From one side,
absolutely terrific this performance so far from Real Madrid. Jan Vertonghen. Here's Dier. Toni Kroos. Jerome Boateng. Sergio Ramos. Carvajal. Boateng. Kroos.
Here comes Spurs with the ball here, trying to find Song. Song's still with it. He can find Eric Dier here. Wanyama still with it. Here comes Dele Alli with the ball to find Harry Kane. Here comes Lucas with the shot.
Great work by the goalkeeper.
But straight to the hands of Navas. Jerome Boateng to kick us off from the back here. We're going to get Carvajal on the ball. Carvajal still on the ball here, chased by Lucas. Come on, Gareth Bale.
Victor Wanyama.
Wanyama with it to find Harry Kane here. Coming towards the end of the first half. Come on. Here comes Aurier.
Wide areas for Tottenham Hotspur.
In possession for Tottenham. Tottenham are really trying to push forward here.
Looks to me, Alan, as the halftime whistle goes, as they're heading towards lifting this Champions Cup trophy. What a good first half.
Well, they've been impressive in everything they've done. It's been a thoroughly polished performance.
Let's get it. We just need to maintain in the second half in here. And we are champions. Looking at the match facts of this game on the Real Madrid side, we do have 3 goals after 4 shots, only 3 on target with a 53% ball possession, 3 tackles, 75% shot accuracy and 87% pass accuracy. On the other side, Spurs, no goals so far but only 2 shots and 2 shots on target with a 47% ball possession, 1 tackle, 100% shot accuracy and a 92% passing accuracy. We need to improve our stats in that aspect of the game, and we should be crowned champions in this morning. Let's get it. Kicking off the second half here from Harry Kane from Old Trafford, trying to win ourselves this Champions League final.
Just to settle down in that dressing room time and come out, produce the best. This final 4 to 5 minutes.
Can we actually add some more goals here in the second half? Really make sure we win this one with a convincing margin.
Real Madrid looking good here.
Find Gareth Bale.
Saw the look from the other player and saw where the pass was going. Read it.
We lose the ball possession. We're going to win it back here. Here comes Benzema to look for Gareth Bale here. Gareth Bale with a shot, but what a deflective save here by the defender. Luka Modric. Come on. Cristiano Ronaldo here trying to find Verratti in the middle there, but he cannot find him.
Spurs get the referee's advantage.
Here comes Song for Spurs to find Dele Alli.
The intentions of the opposition there to make the interception.
Fourth, and we do win the ball possession once again.
Verratti
with it. Verratti here to
Nacho
find
Fernandes. Well, here comes the support.
Back to Benzema. Cristiano Ronaldo to
now
Fernandes.
Nacho.
Back to Cristiano Ronaldo here.
Good defending.
Loses the ball. Spurs in possession, but we do win it back.
Counter-attack stopped in its tracks.
Spurs win it back
Died
once
it
again. And here comes Harry Kane here coming forward for Spurs. Harry Kane coming inside. Forcing a save from Navas and Benzema.
An example of excellent refereeing here. He delayed his punishment. He's going to show a card now. But he wanted that previous attack to at least find its natural conclusion.
Yeah, he's one of our more experienced refs, isn't he? And I like watching him go about his work. Showed his experience there.
Spurs with a corner kick here. Song to bring it in. It needs to be defended.
And they'll have to try again.
Can we keep ourselves a clean sheet in this game? That's still a mess to be seen. What a shot here by Dele Alli to hit the post. Spurs still in possession. What a save by Navas here. Come on.
Throw for Tottenham.
What a shot that was from
Dele
Alli to hit the post.
Another
substitution from Spurs here, their third and final substitution of the game.
Davinson Sanchez.
Gonna try and win the ball back.
This will be a throw.
With a throw in once again.
Tottenham are set up.
Song coming forward here against Luka Modric. Luka Modric wins the ball possession.
Sergio
Ramos to find Toni Kroos back to Verratti here. Come on. Verratti to find Luka Modric to find Karim Benzema here. Benzema back to Verratti. Verratti can find Luka Modric. We can spread the ball to find Carvalho on the other side with a cross. Verratti was in there.
It's the goalkeeper's ball.
To draw a few inches to get to that one. Come on. Toni Kroos.
Really getting at the opposition this far up the pitch.
Cristiano Ronaldo loses the ball for
Eric Lamela.
Lamela for Spurs.
Song
back to
Aurier
here. You can find Lamela once again. Fernandes need to defend Lamela here, but
well, they've got a corner out of that. A bit lucky,
kick.
It was deflected.
Spurs with a corner kick and Song to put it in.
Corner swung in.
Needs to be
really commanding goalkeeper. And that's easy for a player of his ability to catch the corner.
Gareth Bale. Can Gareth Bale actually run with the ball here? You can find it. Luka Modric. Luka Modric
Karim
for
Benzema.
Benzema with the through ball for Cristiano Ronaldo here. Cristiano Ronaldo can find Fernandes on the other side with the through ball for. Come on. Luka Modric.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save. Keeps the ball in his grasp.
Hugo Lloris, as Spurs trying to build something coming forward here. Jerome Boateng
bringing
the ball back. Jerome Boateng once again.
Now Nacho.
Fernandes can find it. Toni Kroos here.
But
gonna find it. Cristiano Ronaldo on this side. What can Cristiano Ronaldo come up with? Cristiano Ronaldo inside the 18. He can find Verratti with a shot, but that was not a good shot at all from Verratti there. Gonna win the ball back possession here. Luka Modric to lose the ball possession of Dele Alli. Dele Alli to find Son. Come on. Jerome Boateng defending. Lamela to win it back to find Harry Kane here. Harry Kane still in possession. He does have a shot in. Coming towards the end of the game here.
Miscued really with the header. Yeah, not known if you
think.
You can see why there with that effort.
Spurs. But we only have two. No, we do get a goal kick out of this one. We do have 2 minutes to play, and it is the end of the game.
Trying to catch the player in possession.
Still leading Spurs here by
three
goals to nil, and the ref blows the whistle. It is the end of the game. We have managed to come back after losing that Spanish Cup final against Atletico Madrid. To come back to redeem ourselves here and win the Champions League final against Spurs.
They deserve it.
This time around, it is
these are special moments
celebrating
for a very successful team.
What a
congratulations
game
to them.
I think this game was very much won in the first half. Spurs, nothing to show for.
Well, it's been a terrific final
here.
And a terrific
course,
tournament
Ramos
right from the early rounds, the group stages.
Lift off this trophy.
And here we are at the climax of
Let's
it all, Alan.
It.
Yeah, it's the pinnacle of club football, isn't it, for these professionals? A day, a season they will never forget. What a campaign for them.
They are Europe's elite. They have won the Champions Cup.
Champions is the cry. Champions. Fireworks in celebration.
Real joy
of
here, total happiness.
Winning
you
this
play
here.
A game for these kind of moments. If you're in it, you want to win it, and
we
they have won it.
Yeah, no wonder they're going to the fans, because those supporters have played a huge part in this triumph. They've stuck by these players. They've needed
second
them the most.
Season, I need to win
special
the
scenes here.
Necessary to win in this league.
Have to have the team photo.
It's time for that.
And they're getting ready for it now.
Yeah, one of those lovely scenes that you'll hang on the wall back at home.
This will conclude the Champions League, and this will conclude the end of the season. I think we have won pretty much every trophy that needs to be won in this league, except that elusive Spanish Cup. I really need to win that Spanish Cup season 2. Hopefully that comes to fruition. But we managed to beat Spurs here by 3-0 in this Champions League final, and we do take this trophy home after playing 3 English teams, quarterfinal, semifinal, and the final as well. So it's been a good season, but only missing that Spanish Cup. Let's get it.
Champions Cup final. Real Madrid 3, Tottenham Hotspur 0.
Looking at the league table here, the final league table of the season, as you can see, Real Madrid sitting at the top of the table here with 38 games. We won 31 games, we drew 6 games, we only lost 1 game in the hands of Barcelona. I had to simulate that game. I think probably that's the reason why we could have lost that game. That's the reason why we lost that game, but in the process, we managed to score 106 goals, only conceding 22 goals and allowing looking at the league table so far, looking at the final league table, as you can see, Real Madrid sitting in first place after 38 games. We managed to win 31 games with only 6 draws, 1 loss, and scoring 106 goals, only allowing 22 goals, with a goal difference of 84 and 99 points in a bag as well. We truly, truly ran away with this league title. Barcelona sitting in second place after 38 games with only they only won 21 games, drawing 10 games and losing 7, only scoring 65 goals, allowing 41. I think that's probably could be one of the worst defensive records. But as I look down, not that worse, but they did allow they do have a 24 goal difference and only 73 points in the bag. Atletico Madrid coming in third after 38 games, winning 21 games, same as Real Barcelona, but only drawing 9 games, losing 8, with only scoring 70 goals, and they do have they only allowed 32 goals and do have a 38 goal difference and 62 points in the bag as well. So from second to fourth place, Espanyol, it was very, very close. Only separated by 3 points, the second team and the fourth team plays right there. Espanyol, after 38 games, they have won 20 games, drawn 11, and lost 7. 60 goals scored, only 40 goals conceded, with a 20-goal difference and 71 points in their bag as well. But looking at the bottom of the table here, Levante shining the floor at the bottom after 38 games, only winning 4, drawing 18 games, losing 16 games, only scoring 37 goals and allowing 56 goals. That's not the worst. And minus 19 goal difference and 30 points in a bag as well. Eibar coming in 19th place after 38 games, only winning 7, drawing 12, losing 19, scoring only 47 goals, allowing 67, with a minus 21 goal difference and 33 points in a bag as well. The other team going down to the being relegated, it is Deportivo. After 36 games, they have only won 6, drawing 19 and losing 13, only scoring 41 goals, allowing 55, with a minus 14 goal difference and 37 points in a bag as well. It hasn't been that much of a terrible season. Now looking at the scoring charts, as you can see here, Antoine Griezmann winning the Golden Boot with 27 goals. Luis Suarez coming in second with 23 goals. Ronaldo for Real Madrid coming in third with only 22 goals so far this season. Looking at the assist department here, it is all Real Madrid. Isco coming in first with 12 assists. Cristiano Ronaldo with only 10, tied with Kovacic, sitting on 10 assists this season. Atletico Madrid's Griezmann coming in fourth place with only 9, and Benzema coming in fifth with only 8 assists this season. Looking at the clean sheet here, of course, Navas had to get a clean sheet here after 38 games. He managed to keep clean sheet 20 times this season. That's pretty good. And Oblak for Atletico Madrid coming in second with only 13. That's pretty good in that aspect of it. But yellow cards here, I really didn't get that many yellow cards this season, and red cards as well. So we're pretty clean in that department. So yeah, this will conclude the end of the season. Hopefully we can have a much, much brighter second season. It has been a really good season, I should say. We won the league, we won the Champions League as well, and other trophies. This will conclude the end of the season, and this will conclude the end of the episode and the end of the season as well. We have had a really, really good season, only losing one game so far this season. I think that's pretty good. For us to lose, I had to simulate the game against Barcelona to lose that. So I think that's pretty good. Hopefully next season we can have ourselves a really, really good season as well. Make sure you guys let me know whom you want me to sign for next season. I would like to change the team around quite a bit, really, just to make sure. I don't know what type of players I'm going to sign, but you guys can let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe, drop a like, and do comment on the video. And I'll see you guys on the next one. I'm out. And this will conclude the end of the season, the end of and this will conclude the end of the episode and the end of the season as well. I think we did have a really, really good season, so cannot really complain about that. I think it was a solid, solid season. The only game that we lost, I had to simulate that game, so I think it's pretty good. Next season, hopefully, it is a similar story. And win all the competitions that we do have to win. With that said, thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe, drop a like and comment, and I'll see you guys on the next one. I'm out.